Are all of the books in APP for every student? How would you use all of them together? Well, why don't I take the lead on that, because I'm actually teaching them more. I would say, yes, all the books are for all students, but the way you use them depends on the individual student. There's all kinds of possible scenarios. I'm kind of an old-fashioned classical piano teacher, so for some of my students, APP is just the dessert at the end of a hearty meal. It's one of the fun pieces that we play. I also find, though, that for younger students, they're a real good way to build basic skills. And, you know, with young students, if you don't call it a job, they like it a lot better.
Yes.
They're still playing, they're still covering their skills, but they're doing it in a way that they think is fun. But the thing that's been real interesting to me, Chris, is, and I know we've talked about this a little bit, is that some students that are decidedly slow when it comes to pieces by Bach and Beethoven really take off on this. It's funny, it's not, the students that have really, really liked this are some of the ones that aren't doing so well in their more, what you might call more standard literature, which I think as a teacher is very cool because it gives me another tool to reach them.
I think the reason for that is also that some of those students probably don't listen to any classical music at all. I know in my own case, my daughter, my elder daughter, had piano exams right up to the end of the eighth grade in the British terms, and she doesn't play anymore. And the reason she doesn't play anymore is that she always did classical pieces with the piano, and she has never had any interest in classical music. And so the kind of it was like the biblical shallow soil, you know what I mean? Whereas my other children, both like a wide range of music, and they happen to play it on the piano, and so they still play as adults. And I think that my daughter would have been better employed, in a way, going to something like American Public Piano from the outset, and just thought, no, I'm playing stuff which I can relate to, and I happen to be playing on the piano. I think that's the thing.
Yeah.
So what she does now, she does very well at open mic contests, you know, like karaoke.
Does she?
She's a great singer. And so she gets a lot more out of that because she fantasizes more about being a singer than about being a piano player. I suppose that's another way of putting it, because how many people fantasize about being a piano player?
There shouldn't be many more. I guess to sum up, really, what we're saying is APP is not a one-size-fits-all thing. It depends on the student, and it depends on you as the teacher and what both your goals are.
I do need to make the point, though, that, and a number of teachers have said this to me already, and that is, if you get through to the end of APP, say level 5, in fact even earlier, but let's say 5, students are actually being prepared to play quite a lot of classical repertoire as well, because the range of influences, particularly on the lyrical pieces for me, is much wider than just popular styles. And I know, to mention a few, one of my big influences on me is the music for Big and Little by Nielsen. And there's also Sati is lurking there.
Debussy.
Debussy for sure. And you might even say Schumann and Grieg and Kabalevsky. I mean, I'm just thinking of various things which I'm aware are sort of lurking beneath the surface of some of these pieces. So it's not as if they're not preparing students to suddenly think, actually, the Kabalevsky Sonata, I love it. And APP's prepared them to play it, you know. So. This series is not designed to turn you into a pop music player, but not a classical player. It's designed to interest your desire to play, to awaken your desire, rather, to play the piano.
Yeah, to play the piano in the big sense.
In the big sense, yeah.